The first thing that I do when I begin an arranging project is I try to figure out what key the song is in. That gets me started. I already found out that this song that I'm going to start transcribing is in the key of F sharp major or G flat major, however you want to view it. So when I play this recording, you're going to hear the notes. And how I figured this out was I went first and foremost to the lowest notes that I could hear, and I tried to play them on the piano. So you'll hear me doing that in the background. So now that I know what key I'm in, I know that these first few notes are going to be F sharp down to C sharp, and I'm using my ears to try and match that up. Now, when I typically arrange something, I use a piano as a reference point for pitch because it's in concert pitch. I can relate it to my score very easily, and I can move around between rolls very, very easily. But if you want to use your main band instrument, that's fine too. If you wanted to arrange on a saxophone or a flute or a trumpet or an oboe or whatever you happen to play, that's totally fine. So, my initial steps, arranging 101. The first thing that you want to do is you want to identify the key the song is in. That's the first thing that you want to do. Now, when you are working in whatever app, notation software, or pen and paper, when you are working in that, you're going to want to look at everything you can in concert pitch. So as you know, you might be able to see right now, I've got trumpet, flute, horn. I'm going to explain my instrument choice in a second, but trumpet, flute, and horn, they all have different key signatures, which means I'm going to have to think through all those transpositions. I don't really want to have to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to concert score. And how to do that on flat.io is there's a concert pitch button way over to the right side here, and you can see now I'm looking at all of the same key signature. And I realize that it's actually in the wrong key. So I'm going to go ahead and change that too. What a great opportunity. So now I'm going to go all the way back. I'm going to go through my menus and see if I can find, here's key signature. There it is. I'm going to select the key signature, and I'm going to go ahead and say that I want F sharp. Where's F sharp? F sharp major. Change the key for all parts. Now you want to stay as organized as you can as you are arranging things. So what I typically do is I start with five different parts, and you can see them on your screen right here. And then I have percussion parts in addition to that. Up on top right now is trumpet. I don't know why it's all the way on top. It's probably the first thing I clicked on. But I have trumpet, flute, horn in F, trombone, and tuba. And I assign specific roles to those lines as I arrange. The trumpet is the loud, loud melody. The flute is a softer melody. The horn in F is a counter melody. The trombone is typically rhythmic support or a low version of the melody, and the tuba is always the bass. So I started with the bass line when I was transcribing, and I found out the first note was F sharp. So I'm going to go ahead and click down here on the tuba, and I'm going to enter an F sharp and see what range I'm in. So I'm going to want that to be an octave lower. I'm going to hit undo. Here's F sharp. To the right note here. And rhythmically speaking, I spent a little bit of time playing along, and I know this is going one and two, a three and four. So F sharp down to C sharp. And I'm going to start to plunk out that bass line. So F sharp, F sharp, F sharp. And then there's going to be a 16th rest. I'm going to hit the next note, another F sharp. And I'm back to eighth notes now. C sharp, C sharp. And just for fun, I'm gonna change this last one to a quarter note. Now, if I go ahead and hit play on this, it should sound like the right song. It's gonna be really slow because my tempo is at 80 right now. So let's bring this up. Oh, that's pretty cool. I'm just dragging and dropping. And two, and three, and four. It's probably somewhere in the 132. 138 maybe range. I'm going to go a little bit fast. All right, let's try it out and see what it sounds like. So that's the first measure. All right, now I know I'm going to have pretty much the same rhythm. So I'm going to spend the next minute or so writing out that part. Okay, I'm almost done transcribing my bass line for the first four measures. And I know that this next rhythm is going to go 1 and 2, a 3 and 4, a 1. So I'm going to finish this measure out. So I already did 1 and 2. I need a 16th note on B. Let's see which one I'm at here. And then a couple of 8th notes on a C sharp. I'm going to dot this next one to get my rhythm as a 16th note. Oops. Let's try that one again. Bum, ba-dum, bum, bum. There we go. And then I want to play this next lick because I think it's cool and I'm making that choice. That little major major chord in second inversion. So I'm going to go back to 8th note because it's all 8th notes. F sharp, F sharp, C sharp, C sharp, A sharp, A sharp, and then a big fat quarter note to finish things out. All right, let's go back to the beginning and see what this baby sounds like. All right, I navigated back to the beginning of the piece, and here we go. Cool. So I realized then I probably did go a little too fast. Let's drag that tempo down a little bit into the 128 or so range. Let's see how that sounds now. Cool. Now, that doesn't sound perfect. That doesn't sound exactly like our bass line. And the reason that is we haven't added any articulations yet. And this is where you can choose to add articulations or you can choose to add them in later. I would say before you get too far, add them in now. Make that bass line and everything you're writing sound super authentic. So.